Introducing NVIDIA DeepStream Inference Builder. Build and deploy real-time vision AI pipelines and applications in minutes. Creating image and video ingestion pipelines for AI models often requires GStreamer expertise and hundreds of lines of code. Instead of writing GStreamer code, you can skip the complexity and focus on models, metadata, and customizing the pipeline for your vision AI applications and agents. You start with a simple configuration file that automatically generates your inference pipeline. Supplement it with an optional OpenAPI spec. Inference Builder blends reusable templates with a standard inference flow to produce your microservice or application. The final pipeline includes model loading, pre- and post-processing, multi-model support, and a built-in API server integration if desired. With DeepStream Inference Builder, developers can now select across multiple backends, unlocking a new set of possibilities. When using the DeepStream Inference backend, you can continue to use advanced features such as multi-camera tracking and connect message brokers for real-time metadata output. And with the TensorRT LLM or Triton backends, you can run state-of-the-art AI models with GPU-accelerated inputs and outputs in your pipeline. Use vision transformers, open-source vision models, and vision language models with DeepStream and the NVIDIA VSS Blueprint for video search and summarization to build new generative AI applications in minutes. Let's walk through how to use DeepStream Inference Builder with a quick example. Here, I'll use a fine-tuned real-time detection transformer model to detect defects on PCB boards. For details on fine-tuning this or other models for your own use case, be sure to check out the tech blog about building a real-time visual inspection pipeline with NVIDIA Tau 6 and NVIDIA DeepStream 8. First, let's explore the Inference Builder GitHub repo. The project is fully open source, making it easy for developers to add custom templates and features. Inside, you'll find all the examples, including those for the three supported backends. The samples are under the folder builder and then the samples folder. Let's review the configuration file under Builder Samples Tau. The idea behind this file is straightforward. The first section defines the model repository. In this case, we'll use the cache folder to store our existing fine-tuned model. The input section lists the supported inputs, which can be either images or video. For this example, we will use images, but the example is ready to support both. The server section defines how we handle the OpenAPI specification. While we have a default implementation of the API, we give developers flexibility to adjust the API calls to match their own specifications. The model section defines the backend. In this example, we'll use the DeepStream backend. Finally, the output section specifies how results are handled. Here, we'll generate images enriched with the metadata produced by the model. Make sure you consult the documentation for the full details. Next, let's open a terminal. First, let's confirm my fine-tuned model is in the correct folder. The next step is to build the application, which will take a few moments. I've included an OpenAPI specification as part of my build argument to make it easy to test my Inference Builder application. Once the build process is complete, the DeepStream pipeline is available as a compressed file. In this case, the file is called Tau. Let's explore the Inference Builder application using Visual Studio Code. The code project includes several folders. The config and lib folders contain standard functionality that doesn't change when you build new Inference Builder applications. The custom folder allows developers to bring their own pre- and post-processing code when needed. In the server folder, the key file is the model.py file, so let's open it. This file includes multiple classes that are always present as part of the templates. In short, these are helper classes that handle configuration, input, and output. The DeepStream backend class is where the pipeline is created using the DeepStream Flow APIs, as shown here. And finally, the call function submits data to the pipeline so processing can begin. Okay, let's get back to our terminal and launch our brand new application as a Docker container. In this example, the container is called TauCV, as defined by the Docker file in the Tau folder. Developers can update the Docker file to their specific project needs. Finally, we can test our container using an OpenAPI call. let's submit an image to see the results. As we specified in the configuration file, the output of our pipeline includes an image and the detected defect generated by our fine-tuned model. DeepStream Inference Builder is a powerful open-source project that gives developers an ultra-fast way to build vision AI applications. We can't wait to see what you create next. Happy deep streaming!